course, John is a good indicator of how much that home court advantage has meant. John has really ignited the team's offense. In those three straight games at home, John has had some big numbers, 16 assists that tied his career high against Minnesota and then against New York and the Lakers, had 31 points in each of those. All three games he shot well above 50%. And again, this is a great opportunity for this team that's two games under 500 now to go over that number.
Four games in five nights separated by 2 days. But now the schedule gets a little bit easier for him. Washington's first shot is a bullseye by Martell Webster.
Among the league leaders in that department, comes away with that first block.
Webster contacts, score the field goal. He has played all 7 years with the Atlanta Hawks. Now Wall penetrates, nice pass to Gortat. Scores on the reverse layup.
Really loves the fact that he's in Atlanta. Mike Budenholzer before the game said he was really surprised by Cartier's physicality, competitiveness, and his ability to rebound and defend. And then Cartier said something interesting, Buck and Phil.
Challenged that shot out there. Of course, Horford has the ability to go around a big man too. Nice shot, John. Pick and roll.
2:15 to go. Wall will try another jumper and hit another jumper.
Starting off this six-game stretch where they have five of those at home, John Wall has been much better at home. He's been good all year long, but I should say his numbers even more impressive at home. He's off to a pretty good start so far tonight. John Wall has made 3 of 4 shots, has 7 points.
Back at the other end, no good. Rebound Wall, he'll try it again. 1-on-3, goes all the way to put it up, and this time in with a left hand.
There's that move that you got so excited about. Beautiful, floats to the other side, puts the reverse spin, and it rims around and out. Right after that, John comes right back, just blinded speed, and gets all the way to make the difference in a win or a loss.
Here they come again. Wall just goes all the way himself. He had a man, but that was a good move. Long shot is good. A 3-ball for John Wall. It's at least his third of the game. Now Ariza fires and hits. Crafton came out and played in Turkey and Italy in 2007. Tough shot in the lane.
Yes, it was. Left-handed, had to scoop it up around the outstretched arm of one of the defenders. Out, the defense collapses quickly. That leaves your perimeter shooters wide open. John with one of his three steals there. A tremendous save, and Washington's able to convert. With good ball movement again, one of three made threes by Martell Webster.
That's what they have. That's the reason Martell had those three threes in the first half.
But I also think that when you start getting those steals and you get those stops with the rebound.
Everything else seemed to be misses. Three in a row, but maybe not. Wall, Gortat, he's wide open. Now he shoots and scores. Nene. How about that play?
Pass off.
Lead is 7. Wall for 3. Wall. Kicks it out. Webster for 3. Nene. Swing it for an open look. That's what you want to do. Wall, good move behind the back, throws it up and in! Sensational play by Wall.
I thought he was a little out of control. Once he went behind his back, he had another defender that surprised him, but John able to make something out of nothing.
Teague went to get in front of him, Wall went behind his back and in the other direction, and then slid inside for 2 off the glass. Wall and the Wizards looking to hang on here against Atlanta, leading 87-79. Ariza for 3. How about that? 90-86. Wall will try and hit it. Wall for Gortat. That screen roll, and he scores. And running here tonight, he really set the pace, unlike last night in Indiana, where he wasn't able to get the pace of the game. He set the tone here tonight.
I mean, he looked for his opportunities and made some real good decisions, especially throughout the first three quarters, and found his players both inside and out. That was a nice pass to Nene, but maintaining a certain level of attack
and assertiveness, aggressiveness.
John. Last night, what was the focus for you to try to improve on tonight?
Man, just attack the basket, man. That's my game. You know what I mean, I'm in better job of shooting my jump shot this year, but I let Indiana take me out of my rhythm of just shooting all jump shots and then attack the basket. And when I get into that paint, I make it a lot easier for my teammates in there. So I just want to do that tonight and be more aggressive.
You had a good teammate tonight also. Trevor definitely delivered the mail on those threes.
He's the best defender on our team, and he gave us a lot. You know what I mean? And he's the corner. Hey, I told him he's a $1 million man in that corner, man. So I know where he at all the time, and it's great to have a guy that trusts me with the basketball, and he trusts me as a point guard. And my teammates love playing with me, and I love playing those guys, but we just got to find a way to keep this going, man. We feel like we're winning a lot of games.
John, you ended this stretch of 4 games in 5 nights, 2 separate weeks with 6 wins. How important is this for you guys moving forward?
We're going to go 8-8. We're going to go 8-0. But we knew it was tough, and we had a tough game against Toronto. We could have won. And in Indiana, we just didn't have it. You know, we didn't give out all our effort, and we lost that game. But we don't mind finishing 6-2. That's a better record in 2 weeks to play that many games.
We'll take it. Congratulations.
Big night for Wall, 26 points, 12 assists, 6 rebounds, 5 steals, and just 3 turnovers. We invite you to join us for our next telecast Monday. The Wiz hosts the Magic. Coverage begins at 6:30. Coming up next, Wizards postgame live with Christy Winter-Scott and Corey Alexander. First, back to the CSN studios for a Geico Sportsnet Central update with Nicole Darren. For Phil Chenier, Chris Miller, our entire Comcast Sportsnet crew, our statistician Paul Evans, stage manager Lori Green, Steve Buckhands from Washington, our final 108-101 Wiz. Phil and I will see you in the postgame show, and again Monday night for the game here against the Magic. Wizards beat the Hawks by 7. Have a safe evening, everyone.